YouTube, how are you doing? This is Spock. Today we are back with the iPhone 3G. Why? Just because I was not happy about the wide door software. Really, it looked good, it looked nice, but since you know the app thing is not working anymore, it makes no use to be on 3.1.3. And also because 3.13 does not have no multitasking, meaning that apps, at least that's how I feel it, that are open cannot be closed until you're gonna reboot the device or maybe respring the device if you're, you know, jailbroken. But if you're not jailbroken, then your device will get very slow at a certain moment, right? So I worked on this iPhone 3G, and I'm listening to my local, let me put it on pause. How to do that? I just turn off the volume. So I already made a very beautiful phone of this device, but I'm gonna tell you what I did and what you should not do and what you should not try and whatsoever. Okay, so if you were also on the wide door software, the 3.1.3, then I would advise you to put the phone into, just hang it to iTunes, download 4.2.1, okay, and let iTunes restore the phone. Okay, though. So, and after that, we're gonna jailbreak the device. Tools will be in the description. And let me tell you about how this jailbreak works. Okay, so you have the 4.2.1 IPSW somewhere in your downloads, all right? You download the 906 beta something from Red Snow that I will have for you. So you open it. By the way, I only have the Mac version. Oh my God, I never downloaded the Windows version. So if you're on Windows, then probably you must go and find it for yourself. It should be out there somewhere. I think I saw it, and maybe I should look it up for you, but I'm just thinking of it. 1 second. Sorry, that was my brother Eric calling me. He just got a Lenovo tablet with Windows 8.1 with Bing, so he's asking me what he can do and how we can, because he's not happy about how the device is running. I said Thursday, because today I'm kind of, yeah, I have other plans. We must also go take some old PowerBook. I found the old PowerBook G4, very nice device. I'm not sure if it's working, but I'm gonna go see. So more of that in my next videos. But to get back to the iPhone, the 3G, as I told you the last time, Winterboard was not showing up. Okay, so in this video you're also gonna learn how to fix that on the 4.2.1. Of course, we will need to be jailbroken. So let me tell you about the jailbreak process. So you open Red Snow, okay? And then you will see a little thing says browse. You must make sure that your phone is into a DFU mode. You know how to put your phone into a DFU mode, right? You turn it off, and then you press power on. And the moment you see the Apple, you hold the home button. Yeah? You keep holding, and then you're gonna see, poof, the Apple will go away. The moment you see the Apple goes away, you say, 1, 2, and then you let go. But you keep holding the home button. Make sure that the cable is connected to iTunes. It doesn't matter what version of iTunes, the latest iTunes is just fine. Make sure it's connected. And then iTunes will say, it found a phone that need to be repaired. Okay, at that point you can close iTunes. All right, you start up your Red Snow. Because it's one of the first versions of Red Snow, it will not say found 3GS connected in any kind of mode. It won't say anything. You will just see the Red Snow, and you will see a little browse button. You're gonna see that all in the video, but I'm just explaining it to you. Then you hit the browse button, and then you browse for 4.2.1. Okay, so that is kind of cool, because if we wanted to jailbreak 3.13, then we also needed the IPSW 3.1. Otherwise, we could not jailbreak it. You know, we would then point to, 3.2. Sorry. Apologies. So, 3.13, then we needed the 3.12. That's correct. That's what I said, right? So, the previous version will be used to point Red's node to. So, the 3.13 can be jailbroken. But in the 4.2.1, it's not needed to point to a lower version. You can just point to 4.2.1. It will say IPSW is recognized. Okay. And then the minute it's recognized, you can then hit next, and then you will see multitasking, background wallpaper, and Cydia. You will see Cydia, and I think something else is selected. You can select background wallpapers, and you can also select multitasking. I would select multitasking. It's really handy, so you can and turn off the apps that are running on the background using all sorts of memory of the phone. You know, this phone, you must try to keep it as light as possible, you know, in running apps. Okay, so what I also did, and what you will not see in the video, but I'm going to tell you about it, so you can make a registration of that. I was trying to be smart, and I thought, you know what? This thing is on 4.2.1 original firmware. I'm going to jailbreak it, but I will not install Cydia. I will just go for the multitasking and the background wallpaper, and I think there was another thing that you could select, but I did not select Cydia. The jailbreaking went fine, everything went fine, but then it hung into the Apple for a very long time. So I hard killed it, you know, and put it back into a DFU mode, and the video is gonna start where I'm gonna discover that, you know, the thing is just hanging in the screen. Because all that previous what I did is way too much footage to show in the video. That's why I'm saying it in words. I hope that you kind of listened, you know, these last minutes that I've been talking, that you kind of have some common sense of what I'm saying, you know. So, what we're going to do, we're going to jailbreak the device on 4.2.1. Well, in fact, no. We will not do that. We're going to put the phone while it's hanging and not booting anymore because we did not install Cydia. Yeah, we're going to put it back into a DFU mode. And we will find out that that is still possible. And then we're going to fix it with iTunes. Okay, that's the procedure. When the phone is fixed with iTunes, we're going to then go back into a DFU mode. And then jailbreak it the right way with selecting Cydia now. You know, to on 4.2.1. It will be an untethered jailbreak, so that's really cool. So you don't need Red Snow to boot up the device. It will be untethered, meaning you can reboot, turn off the device, put it on, everything will still stay the same and work. However, while jailbreaking, I also thought, hey, you know what? In this video, we also gonna fix Winterboard. All right? Winterboard will be giving you this look and feels. And I don't know if you can see it a little bit, but I have new look and feels, as you can see. And this is all happening on the 4.2.1. Let me show that. Look at the settings. We're going to get all of this, okay? In this video, you're going to learn how to do all of this. Let's go to the settings, info. And let me kind of show that to you. We have 3.8 gigabyte available, and the software is running on 4.2.1. Can you see that there? Okay. So, and in this video, you're also going to learn which Navi you can use. And I'm also going to test the Navi because I need to make a drive soon to go get these devices, and then we're gonna make a video about that, and we're gonna use this Navi. And only thing that I once in a while have here, you see this extra screen that is kind of, yeah, sometimes stocking in there. So I wouldn't use that too much. Here you can see that I have a YouTube icon. And this YouTube icon is, in fact, it's a tab from YouTube that is leading to all Bonanza videos that I added to the desktop. Okay, so if this thing is gonna go and on YouTube, it's gonna show me the complete list of all my Bonanza videos, but also other videos, you know, full length videos. You know, on YouTube we have all sorts of videos, you know, and I can watch films. Okay, complete films I can watch now, and my YouTube works again. So that's how I fix my YouTube. It's not the best way to fix it, but it works. We also have we have VoIP Booster. Yeah, better than WhatsApp. It works, always works. We have a world radio, shoutcast radio, so I can listen to any station out there. Okay, we have what is this? We have a scanner, and this scanner will let me listen to the live ATC of Airport Ilde. This is how it looks, but it also has some ATC broadcasters. You will get one time pop-up, and just wait for it, and you can put in your name, or you can say no thank you. Alright, and then up here you can go for all the scanners in the world. You can go hit and hit scanner, and you can hit most popular, you know, and then you will get all the latest broadcastings with all these listeners. Oh, there you go. And then it's gonna load. It's a very nice player, and I found it with a lot of work. Hours and hours of searching and testing, and you know, I've been doing lots of things. So let me see, it's you see. So I can listen to American police radios from all over the world. Fantastic app.
It's 5325 East Robert Cannon, John 4, apartment 2104.
This is really cool. I really love this. So I'm going to turn it off. We can even record with this thing. We can even record this broadcast. And the coolest of this is, of course, the multitasking. We can go ahead and close all the apps that are running on the background. You see that? So that is kind of really cool. What we also have now is a Navi. Yep, I found a Navi in the App Store. All these things I found in the App Store because I could not believe that Apple would not have any common sense for the iPhone 3G users anymore. I just could not believe it, you know. So I went looking and I found a Globetrotter. Yep, Globetrotter. It even got me my Dutch maps. So I'm gonna do a test with this thing. This thing is gonna navigate me to where I have to go. I have a ride to make in a couple of minutes from now. And I'm going to make a short video of that as well, how that is going and if it's working. It has voices, it has everything, and it connects via the GPS. It downloaded Benelux for me completely free. So that was really, really nice. As I promised, I would make a review of navigation with the iPhone 3G, and I just did. And it brought me all the way exactly where I had to be. It was unbelievable. It was a very nice trip, and I'm doing this with the iPhone 3G and with the app that I showed you. So now we're gonna go to our second location, to address in the Netherlands, like that. And then I think we should hit straight.
And then, oh yeah, plaats spacer. Oh yeah, we must select the street. And now I'm going to select the street and we're going to do some Navi. Okay, do welcome back. Only issue.
Rechts off.
Oh, it's there, Rick.
Yeah, for sure.
It did not stuck. I wanted to say the only thing is that you must reboot it after you put a new address when you arrived at your old address. But it will do as if it was stocked. But after a couple of minutes, it will, you know, bring you to the route where you have to go. So I can say thumbs up for this navigation software. Really, thank you so much. I think it was very nice traveling with this thing, and I'm going home again with it. So thumbs up there, all you iPhone 3G users, but I think also users on 3GS and 4 and 5 can get this fantastic software. So link will be in the description, or the name and how to get it, and go get it and enjoy your iPhone 3G.
And here you can see, you can Navi, you can go to any place you want to go to where you have the maps from. I can also download Germany and so, but I don't need that. These maps are way too big. So it's just fine. I have the Netherlands. Netherlands was only 93 megabytes. So yeah, all these things you're going to learn, but you're also going to learn how to get your system like this. Okay? How to kind of get this beautiful look and feels as well. How to get Winterboard working so you can give it your own look and feels. If you want to make it Android or you want to make it anything, you know, it will be up to you what you want to do with it. But this all you're gonna learn in the video. I know it was a long intro, but I show you know, long videos, and I show you things that you don't find here on YouTube everywhere. So only you that are kind of listening and watching my videos, you will know whatever I'm kind of doing, and you will get your profits out of that. So let's get to the job that will start now with iPhone 3GS hanging and not booting up because we installed we jailbroke it, but we installed everything except Cydia. It looks like La Mademoiselle died. She's just hanging to this thing. I kicked it, how you say that, I turned it off, hard turned it off, let it boot again, and this is what we see. There's not much going on here, peeps. So let's just kill it again. Let's see if we can get into DFU mode again. Power on, home. Home and power. Let go. Keep holding. Let me see if iTunes is finding something here for me. If it found something. Okay, it found the phone. So the phone is still able to go into a DFU mode. That is very, very nice. So, I don't want to do that. Go away. I'm gonna say fix the phone. I could also see, you know, in fact, I don't want to install Cydia. I really don't want to install Cydia. Hold on. You know, we're gonna try something else. Let's see if we can fix it from out the recovery. It's always good to try things that you never tried before, right? So there we are. We say finish. We go back to Red Snow. We open her again. We select the 4.2.1 that it corresponds with. There it is, 4.2.1, processing firmware. Let's go next. In some way, because I did not install Cydia, the phone did not boot up. got stuck. I only wanted the multitasking possibility. I didn't want no CDR. You see? CDR must be installed. I just wanted these two. Okay, let me see something. If that will work. I thought that this was an untethered jailbreak. It is an untethered jailbreak. This will never work. Crazy business again with this phone, peeps. Processing firmware. Next. So jailbreak is not working without CDR. CDR must be installed. So you cannot say, hey, I only want multitasking and jailbreak without CDR. So the only way is to put CDR away and never one day open it. So let's enable that. These two things here. We enable home screen wallpaper and multitasking. And this should do it. Boom, waiting for reboot. Oh, it's not even rebooting. So this is the only way that we can fix this, peeps, is with iTunes, with our fantastic, beautiful iTunes, with the doctor of the iPhones. iTunes is the doctor of the iTunes, of the iPhones, huh? It says iTunes found a device that is very badly, very sick, that is very, very sick. So what you gonna do? What you gonna do? Well, let me see if it now kinda gonna boot. If this thing will work. Cause yeah, you know, we're doing all these crazy things with these phones. But these crazy things can also lead to disasters. That a beautiful phone like this dies forever. That it won't work anymore. And that is a pity. Because it's still good to watch videos. It's still good to, you know, listen to music. Etc. Etc. Okay. I see some light is going on there. Yeah. Boom. Okay. We're back. Thank God. I'm going to do this real fast. Okie doke. We're booting again, my friends. There we go. And now it should boot up just fine. But we are back to where we were. So we learned that we cannot do a jailbreak and not install CDR. So we cannot give this thing extra functions and not install CDR. Because CDR need to be installed. Why? Because CDR is going to upgrade and it's going to do some fixes as well before you're going to run into problems because of the jailbreak. So, tja, only thing I can say, peeps, is I need to do more testing to see if I can get some Navi on here. Okay, we're back to jailbreaking because it made no sense at all. because I could not even install my own apps that I still had kind of lying around. I found a disk with all sorts of little apps that I still had from the past. I never knew that I still had the thing. And I found some old apps that I was using kind of frequent on my iPhone 3G and GS at that time. These are old apps that should work on 4.2.1. Because at that time we were all on 4.2.1. And yeah, in fact, I'm trying to find a way to still give some use to this old device without it being kind of all stupid and, you know, not working and can't do this and can't do that. It should be able to do several things still. And navigation is one of them. This was a very nice Navi, I remember, when I had this way back in use as a navigation for the car. And I think there are even apps for, you know, for planes, for pilots. There were several apps for this device. And in fact, if you don't have these apps anymore, then it's very sad for you. That is just how it is. That while this device is still very, very nice. And I think if you took good care of your iPhone 3G or even 3GS, you know, you will have a nice little toy, nice little computer to play with once in a while to do things that you don't do with your, you know, with your quad core and your 8 core and octa core phones. So yeah, that's it, peeps. These are the things that we like to do still. What you're seeing here is some old school hacking. This is really old school. You don't see these things anymore. You know, soon it will not even be possible to put iPhones into a DFU mode anymore. Thing won't exist. Remember when we did the jailbreak just now? We only selected multitasking, background wallpaper, and in fact we deselected Cydia. Well, if you do that, we already learned that the phone will not boot up. Okay? The phone will be stuck on the Apple logo. So now we did install Cydia. This should be an untethered jailbreak. Yep, 4.2.1. All the tools are in the previous video, the second video that I created about iPhone 3G this last week. So if you're kind of also having a 3G and you're looking for the tools, I have all the tools. Please read the manual, which one is for which one. But you will find out easily, because when you're gonna try to point to the device, it won't work. So there we are, baby. Ticks. Monday, the 20th of February. Look at that. Nice, no? Oh, you cannot see properly. You see now? So this is original Steve Jobs, okay? So now this phone is jailbroken. I just booted up Cydia. So the waiting will start. The waiting times just started. And I'm just going to let this go, okay? And when this is done, I'm going to get back to you. Okay, it went back to the home screen and we restarted. It's asking us what we are. Of course, we are a user. We are not hacker. And we are not developer. Please, don't you click one of these. You're going to mess up. So we're going to let this go, the updating. And when this is done, I'm going to get back to you. Now, the last time I found out that it was impossible for me to install WINTERBOARD. I have no idea. Oops, sorry for that. I have no idea why that was. Okay? So it's downloading the packages now, and I'm not going to do a search. I'm not going to do anything. I'm just going to leave it like this. Okay, as you can see, it's back. I'm going to do a complete upgrade. Volledige upgrade. Volledig means fully. And here I'm just going to agree. So I'm just going to leave it. I'm not going to touch it because after this, I'm also going to show you how to get Winterboard fixed on your iPhone 3G on 4.2.1 so we can team it and, you know, give it our own brand new looks. The last time we could not do it because we did not have the knowledge, but now probably we will be able to do it because I did a little bit of updating of my brains so we can, you know, do even more beautiful things. But more of that when I'm back. Okay, peeps, I'm back. I got two strange devices in the house that I will have to fix. So now we upgraded Cydia to the max. Okay? So now what we need to do is we're gonna get iFile. Okay, there we are. Let's find iFile. After very long searching, it found it. Here it is, iFile. Let's install it. You must have patience. You must have a lot of patience when you do this. Make sure that when you do this project, installing things, that you're also doing something else. I'm also working on another project on the background. So I just put this away. If it takes too long, I'm not even looking at it, and then suddenly it's there. So I'm not waiting for the device. The device is waiting for me. You see? You just change it around. So then you don't get crazy in your head. Otherwise, if you look at the spinning wheel, all this, you know, you get dizzy. You want to kind of give up. Vomit. So we're gonna install this. Don't tap it like, you know, just one time. It's busy, see? We will have to add a repo, and I'm not even sure if the repo is still there. Oh, sorry for the cracking of the mic. Let me fix that. So that is also the question. We will also have to download lib height because we're gonna kind of now fix the Winterboard. And I just hope that just hope that the repo is still there. It's powered by 7bub i3 or 7bubble trees GitHub. So that kind of looks promising. Okay, this is installed. So now it's gonna load the things again, so I'll be back when it's done doing this. After some minutes, we can go back to Cydia. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna look for after the loading is done. Okay, we're back. Now we're gonna look for You will find out if you're going to install Winterboard now. Winterboard. It will not show in the settings. We can install and we can downgrade. So what's up with that? Let me look at downgrade. Okay, no, I'm not gonna downgrade. So that means, is it already installed or what? It's already installed. Okay. So if it's already installed, then it should be in here, right? It's kind of white. See something? And you can see there's no Winterboard. You see? So we need to fix that. And we're gonna fix that in some steps. We first gonna downgrade CDI substrate to the lowest version possible. And after that, we're gonna also downgrade preferences to the lowest build. And then we're gonna install lib height. Okay? And when we did that, then we're gonna be just fine. Because then we're gonna add some repo. So we're not gonna look at this. We're gonna hit search. Okay. And we're gonna first go for CDI substrate. Remember that we did a fully upgrade. There it is, CDI substrate. And we're gonna hit change and we say downgrade to the very lowest version that you can find. Just step it and wait a little bit. Double tap it. Give it a little Roger D there. And we're downgrading the CDI substrate. Just give it some time to do. Always takes a little bit. In the next step, it will tell us to restart Springboard. So that's exactly what we're gonna do. And then it's gonna load again. After it loaded, we hit search again, and in the search we type preference loader. There it is. See that? And we also okay, the preference loader was not even installed yet. I think we should have install in here. So let's first install it, and then we will have to downgrade it to the lowest version. So when it's installed, we're gonna hit change or whatever it's saying. In Dutch, it's something like, what was it saying? We will see in a second. When this is done, I'll be back. And again, we will have to restart our springboard. We give it a little middle finger there. So it's restarting the springboard. Cheap. Now we will have to go back and find preference loader again and then downgrade it to the very lowest version. Okay, though. So we go back to Cydia and we let it load again. Okay, we're back and we now gonna work on the downgrade of the preference loader. So we hit search, we give it a little tap there, and we type again preference. Loader, there it is. We're gonna hit, after it's done with loading, we're gonna hit modify. Okie doke, welcome back. So now we're gonna hit modify. And as you can see, we cannot do a downgrade. So that is kinda sad. Okay, so let's go ahead and find Winterboard. I didn't see a little green dot. Winterboard. We're gonna let this load. Welcome back. As you can see, I don't see no little green dot here behind Winterboard. So I'm gonna install it, but it says modify, so it looks as if it's already installed. I'm just gonna say install. And after this we're gonna do a reboot, because officially after the install of this, it should be there, but it won't be, and that's what you're gonna see in this video, so you can understand how it works, this process. I'm gonna say bevestig. I think we will have to reboot after this anyhow. I think it's gonna say reboot system. If I can remember that well from the past. Yeah, you can see, as I said, it's gonna say reboot the device. So let's reboot the device and see what's gonna happen. would be really cool if Winterboard would be there, but it won't be, because after this we're gonna download libhide, and then we're gonna add a repo, and in that repo we're gonna download old depths by 7 bubbles, and then we simply gonna install the Winterboard package after that by going into downloads. So that's how to do it to get it on, to get it working on the 3G. And you see these steps take long, eh? This takes at least, you know, I'm kind of pausing the video when when it's searching, then I'm kind of putting the video on pause, so you're not having the waiting times that I'm dealing with at this moment. I'm not including them into the video because it makes no sense. It will cost me only megabytes. Power button is still very, very good. So are the volume buttons. And even this thingy here still feels very good. Okay, so hello, welcome back. So we should not have Winterboard yet. But if it's there, it's gonna be fantastic. But it's not. So keep dreaming. Okay? So now we're gonna fix Winterboard. We did everything already that we needed to do. The first steps. We have everything installed. Winterboard is installed, etc. And probably before we're gonna go get libhide, we're gonna first go to the preference loader again and see if we can downgrade it, if there's a possibility to downgrade it, or only an uninstall function. Because it might be, it could be that because of the installing of Cydia, the preference loader can be downgraded now. So after the loading, I'll be kinda back. I think it's there already. Search. Okay. We go once more for just to make sure. We don't want to make mistakes. There it is, preference loader. We don't want to make any mistake. You see, wijzig. We cannot, now we know we cannot downgrade. Okay, so now we're gonna go back to search. And we're gonna look for lip height. Lip height, you see, lip height, and we're gonna install it. Install. Schema uit, schema uit, schema uit. Mijn vader is veel sterker dan de jouwe. Schema uit, schema uit, schema uit. The guy singing, my daddy is much stronger than yours. Get away, get away, get away. My daddy is much stronger than yours. Get out of here, get out of here, get out of here. Yep. So, it's installed the libhide. And after this, we will need to add a repo. And I just hope, for God's sake, in the name of the Apple gods out there that this lip height is still available, my good friends. Restart the springboard. We do that, of course. We don't want to piss off any little app there and whatever code. So we restart the springboard. Cheap. Welcome back. Okay. So what happened? Okay. I thought I messed up. Okay, so there we go. Alright, so we go back to Cydia, my people, and then we're gonna select a repo. So we're gonna go to sources, schema uit. When this is done, I'm gonna get back. It was kinda fast. Okay, we go to sources here, peeps, sources, and then we're gonna say modify and then add source, and then we need 7 and then bob with 3 B's, bubble. 1, 2, 3, and then an L, bubble, and then 3S. This is not 3G, this is 3S. 3S, and then dot git hub dot IO. Okay. The address was not with 3 B's, it was with 2 B's. I went and looked it up on GitHub, and it's 7 bubble 3s.github. And now it added the repo. So now we can continue with the fix. Fantastic. Fantastic. This is very, very nice. That is very, very nice. And when this is done, we're gonna go ahead and download all dApps, whatever that is. So we just added the repo, be right back. Okay, we can go back to Cydia. Now we have this repo, we can go ahead and look for old dep. Old dep. Okay, and there it is, old deps. You see that? Old deps. So we're gonna install that one. For older iDevices, see that? Just some old apps for older iOS versions. They will be placed in Far Mobile Download Old Apps. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's install them. Fantastic. This is a very nice video. I think it's the only video here on YouTube showing this process for this phone. At least in 2017. Okay, installed old depths. It's done. It's gonna read all the data. Okay, we can go back to Cydia. In fact, now we can close Cydia. We can go back to the home screen. We go to iFile. Let it load. It will ask us if we want to register. Okay, so we must go to FAR, mobile, and then downloads, and then old apps, later, and then old apps. And up here, you're gonna see WINTERBOARD. You see that? Here you will, oh, I'm so sorry for that. Here you're gonna see WINTERBOARD, the last one, all the way down. Just tap it and install it. Okay, it's done. So now we're gonna reboot the device. We're gonna turn it off. And then, of course, I'm gonna give this thing the latest look and feels. I think we deserve to do that after all the hassle and all the waiting. We deserve to be rewarded with a beautiful device, you know, a beautiful version of 4.2.1 that will represent the latest look and feels. I think that is kind of nice, right? As a reward. So after this, we're going to install the 7, because now WINTERBOARD will be in there, okay? And I want to give a special thumbs up and credit to 7Bubble3S from GitHub, because thanks to this guy or girl, whoever it is, thanks to this person, this human being, this what we just did is still possible in 2017. I think that we should honor that, okay? We should respect that. This man will be credited, the company will be credited, or whoever these guys are will be credited in this video, because thanks to them, this what you're gonna see is possible. There it is, cheap, click, and now we should have WINTERBOARD. Now WINTERBOARD should be installed, 100%. Where is it then? Oh my god. It never installed. Does it make an icon or so? Ah, there it is, WINTERBOARD! Etc. So what we now gonna do, my friends, we're gonna update this phone to the latest look and feels. We're gonna update it to the latest look and feels, my friends. So when this is done with loading, cause you know we're not gonna waste megabytes. My whole Mac stocked up. I don't know what that was. Okay, so we're gonna look for iOS 7 SD search. Okay, we are back, my peeps. Here you can see 07. I don't even know what I'm seeing. Oh, here it is, iOS 7 SD. Okay, so let's give it a little install there. go. So if you see that this video is kind of going a little bit fast, it's because I'm once in a while pause. I press pause, you know, so you don't have to look at all the loading, etc. But when you're gonna do it yourself, I can tell you I've been busy for more than 2 hours now, just to get WINTERBOARD working. You understand? So it's not easy. It's easy, but, well, it's kinda advanced, but it's not that hard. You just must do it step by step. And make sure that you don't miss any step. Otherwise, you know, it will just not work. As you could see, the preferences loader, we could not downgrade it. So in fact, yeah, it still worked. So that's probably because, yeah, I'm not even sure. It was probably already on the lowest version. So that's all good. But you must know these things. For instance, if you're gonna jailbreak iOS 6.16 on the iPhone 3GS, you will also find out that WINTERBOARD is not there. But in the 3GS, it's kind of easier. Only thing you have to do is download CDR substrate to the lowest version. Okay? After you did that, then WINTERBOARD will be there after a reboot. But if you don't know it, you must know these things. Because if you don't know, you're gonna suffer, my friend. And you will think like, why is this bloody thing not working? It's just because of the old depths, man. The old depths. It's all about the old depths. You know, old depths is, it's like, you know, old. It's like the Bootia 32.EFI. If it's not available, these so-called cheap Windows 8.1 and Windows 10 tablets that are being sold, in fact, are using a combination of 32 and 64-bit hardware. So now we have that installed. So that means if you're gonna do an install with only Bootia 64.EFI in the system, in the boot medium, then it will not work. You must get the Bootia 32.EFI. So here we're gonna say iOS 7 complete. I think that's it. WINTERBOARD, and then respring, and we should be welcomed with a very nice home screen. Cheep. Hey, that was in stereo. Did you hear that? That's timing. It's all about timing. Life is about timing. Oh, look at that. Bonjour, bonjour, bonjour. What is your name? Hello, hello. Ah, treble. Treble. How about the settings? Oh, the settings are still. Oh, wait, let me see. Oh, no, the settings are also nice. You see, but this is not the, the complete. Theme that I want, but it already looks nice. How about, what is this? I saw my keyboard popping up. Okay, let's go back to this. Looks nice. Oh, you cannot see it, man. You see that? It changed a little bit. It's not so colorful, but there's another theme that we're gonna get. Let's do one more flash. Well, I'm downloading an even bigger package now. This one calls itself iOS 7 theme complete. So yeah, let's just take a look what it's all about. I don't hope I break the phone, you know, because it happened to me before that I installed the theme and it never warned me that the theme was not suitable for, you know, for the operating system. And then suddenly nothing worked anymore. No touch screen, nada. Only thing I could do was restore the phone back to new. So that was kind of sad at that time. I don't hope I run into a thing like that, because this is a long video again, and it gives good information about this phone. Although you see that you need time. Time must be at your side, you know? You know the song? Time is on my side. Yes, it is. If time is on your side, then you can do this with the iPhone 3G. If time is not on your side, my friend, forget about it. Get busy. Listen to Sean Paul. Shake that thing, Miss Annabella. Shake that thing, Miss Yo Rebecca. Jody and Rebecca. Then you must go do something else and get busy. I have time on my side, man. That's why I'm doing this. I just have time on my side. Nothing wrong with time on my side, man. Listen to some good, nice reggae music. Chilling away with some good old iPhone 3G. Nothing better than that. Some nice soup boiling in the kitchen. I love the smell of garlic and peppers. Beautiful. And the chicken. Yum, yum, yum. What is better? So this might take a while, my friends, as you can see. No need to show you the real time. You know what I'm also wondering? How slow will this phone become after installing all these kind of big packages on it? That's also the question, huh? Because all these things must load. So we're not gonna hit the home button now, we're just gonna let it load until it's done. Okay, there we are, we can go back to Cydia. Done. And if you want white text, you must get white icon text. But let's first go take a look at the theme. Let's see if it's any good. 35 big megabytes. Poor phone. We must also install... look at that. Gray linen, Velux. Okay. Oh, wow. Look at that, man. I'm gonna turn off the iOS 7 complete. iOS 7 by Bico, we're not gonna look at. Lock screen blue, lock screen gray, okay. Lock screen blue. Apple icons. Auxo. Black label. Icon. I will need white label icon, blue navigation bar, top dock, okay, cool, folder and changer, lock screen, wow, WhatsApp UI, we don't talk about WhatsApp anymore, no lock battery, notification center, iPhone 7 UI, Siri. Oh, you mean Siri? Tones? Oh my gosh, that's a lot, man. Okay, that's for iPad. So we have the UI, the tones. I don't think we... I have two iPhones UIs. I think selecting one is the best thing that we can do. Let's see what we got, peeps. I'm very curious. Okay, Plume. you hear that? This one said Plume, and ding, I get a message. Again, I'm showing you timing. Timing is something magic. Okay. It will take some time before this thing is gonna work. Okay, we're in. Okay, this looks very nice. We have white icon text now, as you can see. Only the music app, you see that? The music player is not updated. We're gonna put a camera here. But this looks kinda good. Do we have a pull-up menu? No. Pull-down menu? No. How about the settings? Nothing new about the bloody settings. So let's go back to Winterboard. I probably did not select something too good. Let's go for this iPhone UI. Green navbar. Maybe the AUXO I must turn off. Lock screen gray. Transparent dock, respring. The sound got updated to... Sounds like an iPhone 6. Although I like my little chicken, I have no problems with the chicken. I think Apple can change that sound back. The Plume sounds very depressing. Plume. It's also in minor. Okay, so settings. Hey, these settings look new. Hey! Yeah, we did it, baby. Look at that. Hey. Yes, bye. Nice. I like. So, I have no problem with this iPad, this, how you call it. I'm cool. I'm cool now. I'm really cool now. I don't even know what I'm starting. I'm starting the App Store. No, I don't want to start the App Store, man. I wanted to change the wallpaper. It looks very nice. Remember? Mother Earth. Boom. Nice. I like it. It's just fine. I'm gonna remove the SD theme and the other 12 megabyte theme. Even the keyboard looks good. You see that? We have updated keyboard. I don't see no pull down. Hey, wait a minute. What do I see here? Let's go to the lock screen. Okay, we don't have that The control center is not built in, so sure. The microphone, I can also change the recorder. You see that? Wow, look at that, man. So how to record? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the same recorder that White Door used. Amazing. Wow. I'm happy. This is my project for today. Look at that, peeps. We're installing a Navi. I found a Navi in the App Store, the Play Store of Apple. The Apple Play Store? No, the Apple App Store. Yeah. And it's downloading the Netherlands. And this was completely free. And I will tell you the name of the app in a sec. And my cards are installed. I'm gonna search, go for the Netherlands. And I think I'm gonna show. It says no GPS signal. Menu, route, go to address. Look at that, man. This is a complete Navi. And the name of this Navi is Globetrotter. It's completely free. Select a location. I'm not even sure if it also has voices. I couldn't find the settings yet. Settings, GPS system, time format, GPS, safety options. Up here we can set a speed alarm, camera alarm, it's on, 50 kilometers, afsluiters on the, nee, opslaan. Route options, fastest route, toll yes, night modus, set, lane assistant installed, detailed, Northern in 2D, Schablonen, interesting points, set, international, Celsius, language, Emma, oh, these are the, let me hear you, Emma, say something, baby. Oh, the sound was all off. Talk.
De eerste straat rechtsaf.
Wow.
Turn at the first left. Turn at the first left. Gire en la primera a la izquierda. Prenez la première rue à gauche. De eerste straat rechtsaf.
Oh, that's such a sexy voice.
De eerste straat rechtsaf.
Rechtsaf. Oh, isn't that sexy? That's one sexy lady, yo. Wow. So, yeah. I must, you know, correct myself. White Door is not anymore the best. 4.1.2 is for the iPhone 3G. Look at what I created. I'm very proud of this, that we fixed the winter board. Look at these look and feels, and let me show you the system settings. There you can see it, 4.2.1. Beautiful. This is beautiful. I was so lucky to find it in the App Store. I was so lucky to find it. So the App Store still supports 4.2.1. At least there are still some apps. Hey, I cannot get back. Go back there. Come, baby. So there are still some apps that are kind of supported. Let me do some multitasking here. And let's turn off some stuff. Boom, boom. And the Navi, when you install it, it kind of two or three times fails. And then just reboot it. With the iTunes, I can download music, podcast. It looks good, huh? I think it looks beautiful. I did a great job on the theming. Oh yeah, and we're gonna go to the App Store. So now we need to install a video camera for, how you call it? Nvidia, of course. Oh boy. Amazing. I'm really happy. I have a Navi. I have great look and feels. We fix winterboard. And we even have a navigation. And I also installed mobile VoIP. With mobile VoIP, you can also place calls to each other. Whoever, you see, I also have credits. I can place phones to free numbers. 31 800 1 2 3 4.
Momenteel kunt u ons via dit servicenummer niet bereiken. Voor zaken gerelateerd aan TNT Post, zoals postbezorging, postbussen, postpakketservice en zendingsnummers van post beginnend met 2S, 3S, CC en CP, kunt u het nummer 058-2.
It works. Fantastic. So I have two phones. I have a normal phone and I have my VoIP phone. And let's look at the look and feels of the normal phone. Okay, these are not updated. So as you can see, the team did not update this. But that's good. I'm just fine with this phone. It's cool. The greatest thing of the whole theming, I find the settings. These settings are beautiful for, you know, and also on 4.2.1. This is the latest version that you will be able to install on this phone. But it looks really good. Really nice. You see that? Beautiful. Nice project. The phone will stay on this software because I did a whole lot of work. I'm not even sure what time it is. It's 1 o'clock in the morning. We started this in the afternoon, and now I feel that the phone is kind of finished, you know. Yeah, we have a recorder. We even have NPO, but NPO unfortunately is not connecting to whatever, so nothing works, you see. But I download it from the Apple App Store, so I think NPO can also remove this app. Makes no use to have an old version in the App Store that is not working, you know. That is kind of ridiculous. So but that is not Apple's fault. That is the fault of of NPO. Many hours later, as you can see, my hair got all gray. Oh my gosh, the phone is finally finished, people. It's finally where I want it to be. It is a scanner. I can listen to police stations, to live ATC. I can listen to the radio, shoutcast. All my stations are the reggae station, reggaeton, trance, salsa, you know, my Bollywood music. It's all in here. I have even YouTube icon that will bring me straight to my Bonanza videos, so I can watch my Bonanza videos, my Ben Cartwright videos, you know. We even have a VoIP booster. We can place phone calls via VoIP. Thumbs up to VoIP booster that it still works. Thumbs up to Radio Light that you guys still work on 4.2. Thumbs up to Scanner. I don't even see the good name. Police scanner, thumbs up to you guys. Thumbs up to Globetrotter. Thanks to you guys, we still have a beautiful Navigator. And of course, thanks to Saurek for Cydia and for iFile that we could use it and still, you know, fix our device. I must say, with this device, I can place phone calls. I can navigate. I can make simple videos. I can listen to radio. I can do all these little things that I already showed you. But it took many hours. As you can see, I became all gray.